This is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Carl Schlechter and Amos Byrne. This game was played in Ostend in 1906. Carl Schlechter had white pieces and he started with d4. Byrne played d5. c4, Queen's Gambit, e6, declined. Knight to c3, knight to f6, knight to f3, knight from b to d7, bishop to g5, pinning the knight, unpinning. e3, Byrne castled kingside, queen to c2, all the standard moves, even in the 21st century. b6, c takes on d5, e takes on d5, bishop to d3, bishop to b7, Carl Schlechter castled kingside, c5. Yes, these moves are even popular in the 21st century. It is white to move. Nowadays, white plays knight to e5 in this position, or rook from a to c1 or d1. In the game we have d takes on c5, giving black the hanging pawns. B takes on c5, rook from a to d1, black to move. Byrne played g6, let's take it back. If queen to b6, then one line goes like this. Bishop takes on h7, check. And after knight takes on h7, then bishop takes bishop. Back to our game. g6 was played, protecting the h7 pawn, and also preventing white from playing bishop to f5. But of course, this move automatically creates weaknesses on the dark squares. The game continued. Bishop to b5. King to g7. The king took the role of the dark square bishop. Black is also intending h6 in some variations. White to move. What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? What is the best move for white? Please pause and find the best move for white. What did you find? Carl Schlechter played e4. Absolutely the best move. Opening the game may expose the black king, and also taking the pawn may cause black win quite a big trouble. Byrne played d4. Let's take it back. If d takes on e4, then bishop takes on f6, and after bishop takes on f6, rook takes on d7. Back to our game. So, to avoid this problem, d4 was played. Attacking the knight, which is the defender of the pawn on e4, is Schlechter in trouble. What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Now this is the key moment of the game. Please pause and find the best move for white. Did you pause? What did you find? First, if the knight moves to a safe spot, let's move knight to e2, then bishop takes on e4, and black is better. Back to our game. Carl Schlechter played knight takes on d4, sacrificing the knight for 2 pawns plus the initiative. C takes on d4, rook takes on d4, bishop to c8, defending the knight on d7, more pressure on the knight, a6, bishop to c6, Schlechter also considered bishop to a4, which is another good idea. Bishop to c6, attacking the rook. Rook to a7, white to move and to play the obvious move. Bishop to h6, check was played. King to g8, white to move. Perhaps some players will take the rook on f8, what do you think? But this is not what Schlechter played. How would you continue? Schlechter played the move that applied the maximum pressure on his opponent, and that is e5. This move made Byrne to go into some deep thinking. After a long thought, knight takes on e5 was played. Let's take it back. If black plays something like knight to h5, then bishop takes on f5, and after king takes on f5, rook to d1, and white is winning. Back to our game. Byrne played knight takes on e5, sacrificing the queen for 2 pieces. Rook takes queen. Rook takes rook. Attacking the queen, bishop to d5. Rook from a to d7. Queen to e2. Rook takes on d5. Knight takes on d5. Rook takes on d5. Black has 3 pieces for his queen. That is not too bad, is it? White to move. What is the best move for white in this position? Schlechta played rook to d1. You go to fight for the open file. Bishop to g4. White to move. f3 was expected. But Schlechta played another move, even better than f3. What is it? Well, if f3 is played, then rook takes on d1 check. After queen takes on d1, bishop to e6. White is better. But perhaps black can fight for a long time. So, Schlechta decided to simplify the position. Let's see how he did it. In this position, instead of f3, are you ready to see the move? Rook takes on d5 was played. Bishop takes queen. White to move and to play the obvious. Rook takes on e5, forking 2 pieces. And Mr. Byrne resigned in view of this continuation. Bishop to f8. Bishop takes on f8. King takes on f8. Rook takes on e2. And let's go back. If in this position black wants to save the light squared bishop, then bishop to b4. This is also easily winning for white. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.